Viewers, we are too familiar with the constitution since this is an important thing for any kind of regulatory body to get organized or to get function. So let us see the important part of UGC NET paper 10, paper 1 of the unit 10, that is in governance, quality and administration. So with this regard, we would like to go forward with the topics of an MCQs which are related to the governance, quality and administration. So let us move forward to see. Hello, this is Purna from the, welcome to my channel Purna Educate. In today's video, I am just moving forward to look forward for some MCQs which are related to our UGC NET paper 1. Yeah. So which the first question is, which of the following articles guarantees the right to freedom of the religion? See, before going to all these things, first of all, we should know there are some category called as fundamental rights from the section number 12 to 35. So, with the regards, we can see one of the rights of the, one of the fundamental rights, that is in right to freedom. In that right to freedom, there is a segment called as right to freedom of religion. So, that category comes under the article 25 to 28 deals with the freedom of religion. So, the answer is C, option C. So, article 25 to 28 deals with the right to freedom of the religion. So, in the very next concern, which of the following is not guaranteed by the Constitution of India? So there are some kind of things which the Constitution has been guaranteed to the citizens. So, option A, that is a freedom to own, acquire and dispose of property anywhere in the country. No, the government is not at all, the constitution is not at all providing any kind of guarantee to the citizens in this regard to own, acquire or dispose of the property anywhere in the country. No, but it guarantees the freedom to move throughout the country. The citizen can move throughout the country without any kind of restrictions. And freedom to assemble peaceful without arms. Yes, this is a very important thing. This is a very important thing with respect to the fundamental rights. So the citizens has a right to assemble anywhere peacefully without any arms, and as well as the citizens has a freedom to practice any trade or profession. So with this regard, but one thing you have to notice, the citizens do not have the freedom to own, acquire and dispose of property anywhere in the country. So this was initially in the constitution, there was a right, fundamental right called as right to property. That right has been cancelled from the constitution through the amendment of 44. So with this respect, we have to be very clear that right to property is no more as a part of the constitution. So the freedom to own, acquire and dispose of property anywhere in the country has been removed. So option A, it could be like it has been removed. So next, according to the Supreme Court verdict, the right to property is, see, initially according to the constitution, it was an fundamental right, the right to property, but on the later basis the Supreme Court has been given it as a legal right. So the legal right could be like now the right to property has become a legal right instead of the fundamental right. It was a fundamental right on the later amendment of the 44th amendment of the Indian constitution. The category of the fundamental right has been changed to the legal right with respect to the right to property. So option B is the right answer. Then after, the idea of democratic decentralization in India. So first of all, we should know what is the meaning of the democratic decentralization. So as you all people are aware or not, as we Indians are more familiar with the word democracy. Democracy, what does it mean? Democracy is simple, but it is a people rule, a rule by the people. That whatever the things, whatever the people or whatever the persons or individuals who are being represented on the behalf of the people will be dealt with respect to the ruling and all these things. So these kind of democratic action should be decentralized. It should not be centralized at any part. It should be decentralized towards the various regions in the country. With that respect, so the idea of democratic decentralization has been given or it has been introduced by the Bihar Mehta Committee in the 1957. So you have to be very clear, Bihar Mehta Committee in the 1957 has been given the idea of the democratic decentralization. Which of the following is not a fundamental right? Again, so fundamental rights. So we have the six fundamental rights consisting in the constitution now. So first one, right to equality is a, yes, it is a fundamental right. Right against exploitation is a fundamental right. Right to freedom of speech and expression is also a fundamental right. And right of free and compulsory education is not really and fundamental right. So option D is not right. Option D, right of free compulsory education of all, is not a fundamental right anymore. So we are just moving. What was the sixth one like? Which of the following fundamental rights have been deleted from the constitution through an amendment? Yes, beautiful question. We already discussed in the earlier question. There was a fundamental right which is called as a right to property, which has been cancelled from the fundamental rights. Now it is no more fundamental right according to the constitution. It will be considered as only the legal right in the constitution. So there is a difference between the fundamental right and the legal right. Okay. Fundamental right is like a kind of guarantee provided by the constitution, whereas in the case of legal right, it is a kind of, you know, lawful consideration provided by the constitution. So okay, now the right to property has been deleted from the constitution through the 44th amendment. This is a very important point that you have to consider. The 44th amendment, the word right to property has been cancelled. So, we have to be very clear that right to property was a fundamental right in the beginning according to the Indian constitution. Now, it has been removed through the 44th amendment. So, you have to be very clear, ma. So, option C is a right answer. Yeah. Moving forward to the 7th question, the right to issue the writs for the enforcement of fundamental rights. Yes. So, whenever there kind of, where there is some kind of violation of fundamental rights, the Supreme Court of India has the right to issue some kind of writs. Writs are kind of notices being given for the violating of fundamental rights. So option C, the Supreme Court is like, Supreme Court has a right to issue any kind of writs with regards to the violation of fundamental rights. And how can the fundamental rights be protected by the citizen? So whenever there is a kind of conflict between in a kind of like a protection of fundamental rights, the citizens can directly approach the Supreme Court, who can issue any kind of writs against the authority who has violated the fundamental right. And then the fundamental right which is concerned with the abolition of social distinctions is simple, but social distinctions again comes picture the word equality. So the right to equality is a fundamental right which morely concerned about the social distinctions. Fundamental rights can be suspended during, so generally fundamental rights can be suspended during the national emergency. So whenever there a kind of national emergency prevailed, so normally at the time the fundamental rights can be suspended. So in India past during the Indira Gandhi government, there was an issue with regards to the national emergency where the fundamental rights of citizens has been suspended. At that time no citizen can claim for the fundamental rights. To uphold and protect the sovereignty, unity and integrity of India, a provision has been made regarding the fundamental duties. Yes, fundamental duties. All the citizens are more concerned about the fundamental rights, whereas the government has provided some kind of regulations with regards to the fundamental duties to uphold and protect the sovereignty, unity and integrity of India. So directive principles, and what is the difference between the directive principles and fundamental rights? See, directive principles are the policies with regards to formulation of state policies. So those are the basic guidelines provided to form any kind of rules regarding to the state policy. Whereas fundamental rights are those rights provided to the citizens. Here the fundamental rights are the things which are enforceable, whereas the directive principles are not at all enforceable. So the options B, that which clearly shows that the first one is not enforceable, whereas the later is the enforceable. So directive principles are not enforceable, whereas the fundamental rights are enforceable. Which of the following instruments may be used by the Supreme Court for the enforcement of fundamental rights? As we discussed in the earlier, a writ. The Supreme Court can issue any kind of writ in the case of violation of fundamental rights. So option D. Which of the following writs may be issued to enforce a fundamental right? A very beautiful question and very important question being asked in the many previous year question papers. So you have to be very much focused with regards to which writ can be issued by the Supreme Court. That is habeas corpus. Habeas corpus is an writ issued by the Supreme Court with regards to any kind of violation of fundamental right. Citizen can approach the Supreme Court with regards to any kind of violations happened in the society with regards to the fundamental rights. At the time, the Supreme Court can easily issue the writ against the institute or authority with regards to the violation of fundamental rights. right to free education within the certain limits is, again, you have to very clear, right to freedom education within the certain limits is not at all a fundamental right. It is only the basic guidelines given by the constitution to form a rules. So you have to be very clear with respect to the directive principles. So basic guidelines given to formulate the rules is called as directive principles. In that regard, the state governments can create any kind of policies with regards to the formulation of any policies with regards to providing the free education. So option B. So it can be ensured in the directive principles of the state policy. Which of the following articles deals with the amendment of constitution? So the article 368 subsection 1 is the main important provision which directly concerned with the amendment in the constitution. So article 368 mainly deals with the amendment of the constitution. So we have to be very clear with regards to amendment. Yeah, 368 article speaks about the amendment to a constitution. Distributive justice is a common aim of. Distributive justice is a common aim of the article 38 and 39. So option B could be the correct answer for the question. Which of the following legislative measures introduce the concept of collective responsibility of the cabinet? Yes. So there is a concept called as collective responsibility of the cabinet in India. Though that is like the Minto and Morley reforms has been given. Minto and Morley reforms has been given for kind of what is it called as collective responsibility of cabinets. Okay. In the case of conflict between center and state in respect of subject included concurrent list, you know that there are some kind of subjects in the concurrent list. We have three kinds of lists. One is central list, second one is state list, and third one is concurrent list. So in the central list, whatever the subjects or whatever the items comes in the central list will be under the jurisdiction and administration of central government. Whereas whatever the items or subjects comes under the state list, so it will come under jurisdiction of the state government. Whereas for the subjects or items included in the concurrent list, it will be jointly administered by the central government as well as state government. In that case, if any kind of conflicts arise in the concurrent list subjects, so generally the union law will prevail the subject issues with respect to concurrent list. Union law will prevail, whatever the decisions being taken by the union law will be considered as a final treatment with regards to the concurrent list conflicts. Which of the following legislative measures introduce the concept of collective responsibility of cabinet in India? Again, we are going forward. That is, Minto-Morley reforms has been given the concept called as cabinet. Yes, earlier we discussed, it is like, and Minto-Morley reforms has been given the concept called as collective responsibility of cabinet. In the case of conflict between center and state, again, we are having the same question. So union law will be prevailing, union law. Yeah, we have the concepts here. We have to match the list one with the list two and select the correct answers from the codes given below. The first schedules. The first schedule deals with the list of territory, states and union territories. Eighth schedule deals with the languages in the constitution. And ninth deals with the acts passed by the legislators. And tenth deals with the disqualifications on the ground of defections of the public representatives like MPs and MLAs. So the A is a 1, B is a 2, C is a 3, and B is a 4. So option D will be the right answer. Option D is the right answer. Legislative council in the state can be created by the legislative council in the state can be created only by the resolutions passed by the state legislative assembly. Only state legislative assembly can have the powers with regards to the establishment of legislative council. So you can see here. Yeah, so articles, we have a list of articles and a list of tribunals or whatever it might be with regards to the articles is concerned. Yeah, you can see here article 324, again if you observe here clearly, so yeah, article 324 clearly speaking about the establishment of finance commission. Article 280 speaks about finance commission. Article 324 deals with the establishment of election commission. Article 326 speaks about the administrative tribunals. Article speaks about like UPSC. Article 315 speaks about UPSC. So option 2 is the correct answer. I hope you clearly understood the class. If you really understand, subscribe our channel and click on the bell icon for the more updates. Thank you. Jai Hind.